The UK announces a massive electricity and gas rate hike. Power regulators said the energy price cap will increase by 80%. This means an average household with an electricity bill of £1,700 per year will have to pay a whopping £3,500 come October. Officials blame soaring gas costs after Russia's invasion of Ukraine. The news could not have come at a worse time with winter approaching. Experts believe this will further push inflation upwards and nudge a British economy into a recession later this year. A U.S. senator leads a fourth American delegation to visit Taiwan this month. Marsha Blackburn has said her trip aims to tell Beijing that the U.S. will not be bullied. Blackburn on Friday met with Taiwanese President Tsai Ing-wen.
You are so accurate when you mention the shared values that we have, loving freedom, loving democracy. And it is important indeed that freedom-loving nations support Taiwan as they seek to preserve their independence and their freedom.
Tsai asserts these firm demonstrations of support that Taiwan has received have reinforced its determination to defend itself.
Lately, there had been major shifts in the global landscape. Russia invaded Ukraine and China continued to conduct prolonged military exercises. These developments show how authoritarian countries are disrupting and threatening the world order.
Tensions between China and the U.S. soared to their highest level in decades after U.S. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi defied Beijing's warnings and visited Taiwan earlier this month. Since then, U.S. lawmakers and other elected officials have gone to Taiwan, which Beijing claims as its own. The world narrowly escaped a radiation disaster. That's according to Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky. He says the last regular line supplying electricity to Ukraine's Zaporizhzhia nuclear power plant has been restored hours after being cut. But the plant's six reactors remain disconnected from the power grid. Zelensky blamed this on Russian shelling.
The world must realize what kind of menace it is. If the diesel generators didn't turn on, if after the blackout, the automatics and our NPP staff didn't start working, we'd have been obliged to face the consequences of a radiation accident. Russia's put Ukrainians, as well as all Europeans, one step away from radiation disaster.
Despite repeated calls to stop its invasion of Ukraine, Russia seems to be further bolstering its offensive. Russian President Vladimir Putin has signed a decree which could add 137,000 service personnel to the country's armed forces in the coming months. Currently, Moscow has a limit of just over 1 million military personnel and almost 900,000 civilian staff. The decree comes amid a recruitment drive around the country with large cash incentives on offer. There have been reports recruiters were even visiting prisons, promising inmates freedom and money. Now here at home, fuel prices may increase for the second straight week on Tuesday. An Energy Department official says the estimated price of diesel and kerosene are expected to rise by 5 pesos per liter starting next week, while the cost of gasoline is forecast to also increase by over 1 peso per liter. The official attributes the continuous price hikes to the higher demand for fuel products and the continuing war between Russia and Ukraine.
Sisimula na po yung paglamig sa ibang mga bansa. At saka alam naman din po natin na ang petroleum products or even the LPG eh heating fuel. So doon sa bansang malalamig, ginagamit siya para pang-init po. Tapos may mga bansa din po na harvest season. Dahilan po dito para tumaas ang demand o pangangailangan sa petroleum products, kaya nagkaroon ng mahalan na po na pagbili. At saka nandun pa rin po yung sitwasyon na may tightness na supply.